Continuing our discussion on variables, this is part 2 of the video session on variables. So to add to more information about how to use variables in C, there are a few rules for using variables in C. You need to compulsory declare variables before using them in C programming. You cannot directly just use a variable without declaring or informing the compiler that you are going to use a particular variable. Now, suppose you have to declare a variable, it is also possible to give that variable an initial value. Suppose you're going to read the gender of a person, whether it's male or female. So here it shows you, I have declared a variable called as gender. It's of the type character or char, and I have given it the initial value f. Okay, this is the declaration of a character type of variable as well as the initialization with the value f. Now what happens in the declaration is, the first thing you will declare that the type of the variable. You will say gender is of the type character. Okay, then you will follow by the name of the object. This is an object, variable type object, and then I'll give it the initialization. Now, before I show you this variable declaration, or before I go up discussing this variable declaration, there are certain attributes associated with variables in C. That means there are certain properties of variables associated in C. First thing is, let us take a look at this diagram here, which we referred before. First thing is, the variable has a name, so it is A. There is a value inside a variable, happens to be 262. Alright, there is an address of a variable. In this case, I've just assumed it is 2224. Then there is a size of a variable. Since it's assuming A to be an integer type of variable, the size of int is generally 2 or 4 bytes. So it's going to have a size of 2 or 4 bytes. The type of the variable, A is of the type integer. And here, although I have not given it any initial value, if I don't give an initial value, suppose I declare int x, okay, then what is going to happen is, x is going to be allotted some space in the memory, and this memory at that point may have certain random or garbage values. Okay, so if you just declare without giving initial value, it will contain certain unknown random combination of zeros and ones. That's why we call it as a random or a garbage value. Now let's try to understand a little more about variable declarations by showing different types of variable declaration. This is a simple C program doing almost nothing, just showing you how variables are declared in the right manner. The first thing is, I've included a header file called as stdio.h, although not required here because I'm not doing any printing here. Then I have, using the hash define or the preprocessor directive, I have said hash define lower is 0. So wherever lower is going to occur, it's going to be replaced by the value 0. For example, here lower is going to occur. So before this code even goes to the compiler, this lower is going to be replaced with 0. Now what I am doing is, I am declaring a variable int lower with this value. This is different now. The case of this is different from this. This is lowercase, this is uppercase. So you are perfectly fine. This is 2, 3, 4. I have declared a variable C of the type character with the initial value A. D and F are also character type of variables, but they contain garbage or random initial values because I have not given them any initial values. Now, short is a type of integer which is roughly half of your standard integer. Suppose your integer is 32 bits. Short, you can just think of, just for example, assume it to be about 2 bytes. So it is used to save space where, you know, for example, the age of a person can never be more than 3 digits. Okay, so you can preferably go with short age because it can store, if it is 16 bits, it can store up to 32,767. So that's your, that way you're okay. This is a floating type of variable. I've initialized it to 123.45. Int start, I've initialized it to this particular flow. So during the preprocessor run, it will replace lower with 0. Here I have declared a double variable called as E. Okay, except that I have used another keyword called as const. That means what it says, E is a variable of the type double, but its value is constant. That means you can't change this value of E. If you try to change the value of E in your program, you're going to get a compile time error itself. So I've initialized with some numbers here. This is a very important advice from Dennis Ritchie. Although I may not be able to follow it when I am writing the program because of space requirements so that you can see more clearly, but his advice is excellent. Make an effort to declare each variable on a separate line. This way, the program becomes very readable. If your program is highly readable through proper spacing and indentation, you will require very few or hardly any comments to explain the logic of your program. So please make an effort to declare one variable on a separate line. But just to give you a hint, I may not be able to follow my own advice because I am going to run out of space, so I may type more than one variable.